Alright, we are going to obtain the quadratic equation used to form this particular table. This is what quadratic table. We are going to now use the second method by what? Using the coordinates.
Yes.
So let us use this, this and this coordinates.
Yes.
So let us use x1, y1. It will be equal to what? Minus 2 and a positive 5. Minus 2 plus 5. Then x2, y2 to be equal to what? Negative 1, then 0. Are we together?
Yes.
X3, y2 to be equal to what? 0 and what? Negative 0 and?
Negative 3.
But the general form of quadratic equation is always equal to y equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. So now we are going to substitute each of these coordinates into the main equation. So let's begin with this one. When x equals to negative 2, y is equal to positive 5. Therefore, 5, as y is equal to 5, we have negative 2 squared. Negative 2 squared is positive 4, right? Positive 4 times 8, we are going to have 40. Then remember, our x is still negative, so we are going to get negative
2b
plus c. I call this equation 1. Then we move to the second one. Y is 0 and x is what?
Minus
1. So minus 1 squared is positive 1. Then we have only
a plus.
Then minus what?
B.
Plus
C. Equation 2.
I call this equation number
2.
Then the last one.
Minus
when x is 0,
y
is what?
Minus 2.
Then here y
minus
is negative 3. And the whole of these two terms are going to be 0. So we are only left with
C.
I call this equation
3.
But if you can observe, the value of C is negative 3.
Yes.
So we can substitute the value of C into equation 1 and equation 2. Substitute. Equation 3 into 1 and 2. So for equation 1, when C is negative 3, we have 5 equals to
4A
minus 2B, then what?
Minus 3.
Then we collect the like terms. If you take this one to the left hand side, it becomes positive.
Yes.
So therefore, 4a minus 2b is equal to what?
Yes.
Yes, because if you take this one to the left hand side, it becomes positive. So 5 plus 3 is going to be 8. Alright, I call this equation number
4.
We are still going. Then I will pick the value of C again and plug it into equation number 2. From equation 2 we have equation 2 we have 0 equals to
A minus B.
But we know our C is what? Negative 3. Negative 3. So if you take negative 3 to the left hand side, it becomes positive, right? So we have A minus B to be equal to 3. Did you get it? And I call this equation
5.
5. So now we are going to relate equation 4 and equation 5. And for an equation 4, we all agree that we can reduce this one to their lowest term by dividing each term by 2. So we have 2a minus b and equals to 4, right? Then you bring down equation number 4. Please listen over there, please. A minus b then equals to what? We are going to subtract this equation from this one. So we have
1
minus 3 is 1.
0.
This is 0.
And
this is 1. So we realize that A is equal to 1 from this one. So therefore, A is equal to 1. Then from this equation number 5, if you look at it, we have A minus B is equal to 3. It means what? 1 minus B is equal to 3, because the value of A is equal to 1, right? So you take this one to the right hand side and you bring this one to the left hand side. So we have B to be equal to what? 1 minus 3. And B is equal to negative 2. Now we have B to be equal to negative 2, A to be equal to 1, and C to be equal to negative
3.
So we can substitute all of them back into the main equation. And the main equation Y equals to. And what is our A?
1.
So we already have
x squared.
Then B.
Minus
2 x.
Minus
3.
So now this is the equation.
Yes.